We're here with Eddie Mustafa Muhammad. You became Muslim, right?
Yeah.
Why?
Because at that time, I've been practicing a lot of religion. But I found out that becoming a Muslim, that just opened the door for me to meet people around the world, because I never knew that there was that many Muslims around the world.
Billions.
Yeah, thank you, and I didn't know that. And then, you know, I started traveling, you know, and everybody would greet me, assalamu alaikum, you know, and
then they say, alaikum salam.
Wa alaikum assalam, exactly. It's a beautiful way of life. I think it's the best thing that ever happened to me is becoming a Muslim.
Muhammad Ali, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar II.
Badu Jack.
Badu Jack, well, no, he was born. Wait, your country in Africa is a Muslim country.
Say that again?
Your country in Africa?
Gambia.
It's a Muslim country.
Yeah?
Yeah. But I'm saying he was born a Muslim.
Right.
You joined afterwards.
Right.
Does it help you as a fighter to be more religious, to be spiritual, faithful?
Without a doubt.
Why?
For the simple reason, you go in there, not want to really hurt the guy, but just put enough hurt on him that you got the victory.
To win. Manny Pacquiao recently released a video, coach, saying that he's in talks for Mayweather rematch. Did you hear about that?
Okay, I'm over in China. I didn't hear nothing. I don't know what's going on over there, you know?
If they have a rematch, what can we expect?
Social media don't work at.
Yeah. You know, listen, nobody's going to beat Floyd. So they can have all the rematches they want. Nobody's going to beat Floyd.
Why not?
Because he takes boxing very, very, very serious. You know, and I don't see Manny Pacquiao beating Floyd. Not at all.
How do you see fighters like Badu, who's a champion, versus the champions in your time? What's different?
Well, Badu can fit in with when I was coming through. I mean, we had a murderous role. You know, and this is what I teach my guys. Listen, when you step in that ring, you know, number one, we're in condition, mentally and physically. Now, let me show you how to do this. And we go through some things, and, you know, he's sharp as a razor, and we take care of business.
If you could choose an opponent for Badu, who would you want next? This guy?
Nah, I would like Julio Cesar Chavez.
Okay, break it down. Badu Jack, Julio Cesar Chavez Jr.
Break it down?
Yeah.
We beat him up. That's the bottom line.
That's a big fight?
Yeah, it's a huge fight. We beat him. Listen, ain't nobody going to beat Badu Jack at 68. Nobody. Nobody. The bottom line, I don't care who they got.
He looked great his last fight.
Yep. He's going to keep getting greater and greater.
So last thing, I know your hands are full in the gym. You've got a lot of fighters. But if any fighters out there want to train with you, how do they get a hold of you, coach?
Listen, I'm at Floyd Mayweather's gym. I'm there all the time. You know, they know me. I'm there from 9:30 in the morning, probably up until 4. We'll have guys come to me from all over the world. I got a brand new guy just came from Japan, 6-0, 4 knockouts. I mean, I got it going on over there.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. Thank you so much. Thanks, Badu. EsNews Boxing.com. I'm Melissa Pack reporting.